If you're an off-roading enthusiast or an adventure junkie or just a couch potato like me who binge watches YouTube for hours, you probably already know just what the hell this monstrosity is behind me. But those of you who were curious enough to get here by clicking on the thumbnail, this rubber-riding mini tank is a Sherp, and specifically the Sherp N1200. So while I figure out a way to get down from here, take a look at this big guy. So the Sherp is made by a Ukraine-based company called Quadro. It's designed to be an amphibious all-terrain vehicle, so it can jog, it can swim. The only thing it can't do is fly. So lower half of the body is made from special Swedish steel called Dokol. Now, Dokol steel has very high tensile strength as well as yield strength. What that means is the structure can take quite a beating before it begins to deform structurally. Not just that, it's also coated in zinc, which gives the steel a service life of 30 years. The upper half of the body, however, is not made of steel, it's made of aluminum. Because remember, one of the KRAs of this vehicle is to also float. Now, what else am I missing? Right. The tires. How can you miss these tires? They're literally in your face. Now, you've probably guessed that these tires are made especially for the Sherp, and they're begging for a fight. Not with me, of course, but with the terrain. So these are 1800 section tires running on 25-inch wheels. But the size is not the only thing special about them. These are also ultra-low pressure tires. What does ultra-low pressure mean? So my car, for example, is running 32 PSI. These tires are running 1 to 3 PSI, so that ultra low pressure is for buoyancy in case you have a puncture, the air doesn't come out, etc, etc. So more function than form. But that's not the only interesting thing about them. The inflation system for these tires is from the exhaust from the engine. So the exhaust is channeled through pipes to inflate and deflate the tires. So what that means is you don't need a separate air compressor on board. Now these ultra low pressure tires also double up as the suspension, so there is no independent suspension system, no struts, springs or dampers. The tires take the impact of boulders, rocks, whatever terrain there is, they deform, the air is sent to a system, and the moment they get their shape back, the air is sent back. Now if you're not tired with all that information, there's one more interesting piece of intel. The wheels that you see here also double up as fuel tanks. So you can hold 58 liters in each wheel. And that is apart from the 95 liters in the main tank. So that's 232 liters of fuel plus 95 liters of fuel in the main tank. These tires really help make this vehicle Atmanirbhar. So with that out of the way, let's hop aboard and take a look at the secrets that lie within. So the interior is a fairly simple affair. In terms of instrumentation, you get a screen which relays all the information to the driver, engine temperature, fuel, tire inflation, etc. The other switchgear are fairly simple buttons. So you have buttons for your air conditioning, cabin heater, cabin lighting. When you're on the water, to put the blinkers on, a water pump in case there is water ingress, battery reserve. So there are two batteries, there's a main battery as well as a reserve battery. So you get indicators for the battery level as well. Now, in terms of driving control, you get two pedals and two levers. So you have an accelerator and you have a clutch. There is no brake. Now, the braking function is inbuilt in the two levers. For example, the left lever, when you pull it a little towards the driver, it disengages the clutch. And if you pull it a little bit further backwards, it will apply brakes just on the side of the lever that you're pulling. So that allows the vehicle to turn. In fact, it has a slide steering mechanism which allows the vehicle to turn on the exact same spot where it's standing. So it's fairly cool. Now, in terms of seating capacity, you have two pilot seats up front for the driver and the passenger. The back of the passenger bay can be customized depending on preference. So, for example, in this case, it is customized for seating passengers. So, you have four captain seats at the back and one extra seat in case someone wants to sit. So, the overall seating capacity in this vehicle is around seven. There's another vehicle that is customized to seat seven people in the cab at the back and two people in front. So, along with the driver, you can fit eight other passengers in this. And Sherp says that the vehicle can be customized and modified for whatever purpose it's needed. For example, if there are evacuation missions or overland missions, you can also customize this to have a stretcher inside. So it's fairly customizable, really cool, but the basics of it remain as they are.
The engine is a Doosan diesel unit from South Korea, making 55 HP and 190 Newton meters of torque. It's paired with a 6-speed gearbox from Renault. The gearing is super short and the engine RPM is capped at 2500. In fact, the gearing is so short that first gear is used only for the steepest inclines. To get it moving from standstill, you have to slot it in second gear. All of this combined makes for a top speed of 40 km per hour on land and 6 km per hour on water. Fuel efficiency ranges from 5 to 8 liters per hour. So clearly you're not going to be the fastest person on the road in a Sherp, nor the most fuel efficient. But to paraphrase Einstein, you don't judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree. Where the Sherp does indeed come across as pure genius is where all roads end. This is a mechanical mountain goat on steroids. The massive tires are positioned close to each other, rendering off-road metrics like approach and departure angle, ramp over angle, and ground clearance completely useless. It makes easy work of boulders the size of a small car and can easily take on an incline angle of over 35 degrees and a tilt angle of 30 degrees. There's a separate smaller fuel tank on top that continues to provide fuel to the engine even at steep incline angles, helping to avoid fuel starvation for the engine. After all, don't want to stall. The Sherp also has the ability to turn around on the spot thanks to a skid steering mechanism like a tank. So it locks the wheels on one side, helping achieve a full turn. This makes it hilariously maneuverable, even in the toughest spots. But what makes it truly unique is that it's amphibious. So you're on a rescue mission and the topographic map suddenly throws a lake your way. No problem, just keep going. The ultra low pressure tires provide buoyancy, and the lower body is shaped like a hull to efficiently displace water. While progress is achingly slow, any progress is better than none at all. It's designed to reach places that are hard, in fact nearly impossible to get to, especially in extreme temperatures. And talking of temperature, the Sherp has been cleared to operate at minus 40 degrees to plus 40 degrees Celsius. And now that it has been tested over the past few days in peak North Indian summer, I have been reliably told that its peak service capacity will be re-rated to temperatures above 40 degrees Celsius.
Not that it really matters because it's not strictly road legal, but if you are curious, it's going to set you back by $150,000 plus delivery plus taxes. That comes to about 1.12 crores and some. However, the Sherp N1200 will take you anywhere over rivers, lakes, rocks and marshes, sand, ice, snow, wherever you want to go. So unless you're a United Nations mission or the military or an extreme overlander or just an angry guy stuck in a traffic jam, you're never really going to need the Sherp. But if you are any one of the above, this is going to be your best buddy.